Konnichiwa everybody, it's Ward, and it's time for some The Stanley Parable. This was gifted to me by one of my VIP patrons, JS. Thank you so much for being my VIP patron and gifting me this game. And he has requested for me to play it, and of course, I'm more than willing. He didn't have to ask, I would have still, you know, done a reaction gameplay of it. Anyways, I heard a lot of good stuff about this game. So let's just get to it, huh? It's a bit of a choose-your-own-adventure type dealio. Maybe a bit funny. Doesn't it have like a bunch of narration? The end is never the end.
This is the story of a man named Stanley. Stanley worked for a company in a big building where he was employee number 427. Employee number 427's job was simple.
He sat at his desk. That's a simple job.
And he pushed buttons on a keyboard.
Is that what I'm going
to
do?
Orders came to him through a monitor on his desk, telling him what buttons to push, how long to push them, and in what order.
Sounds kind of boring.
Employee 427 did every day of every month of every year. And although others might have considered it soul-winning, Stanley relished every moment that the orders came in, as though he had been made exactly for this job. And Stanley was happy. And then one day, something very peculiar happened. Something that would forever change Stanley. Something he would never quite forget. He had been at his desk for nearly an hour, when he realized that not one single
order
had arrived on the monitor for him to follow. No one had showed up to give him instructions, call a meeting, or even say hi.
Did everybody disappear?
Never in all his years at the company had this happened, this complete isolation. Something was very clearly wrong. Shocked, frozen solid, Stanley found himself unable to move for the longest time. But as he came to his wits and regained his senses, he got up from his desk and stepped out of his office.
I already got up, huh? I had no choice in that. Can I interact with anything?
But Stanley simply couldn't handle the pressure. What if he had to make a decision? What if a crucial outcome fell under his responsibility? He had never been trained for that. No. This couldn't go any way except badly. The thing to do now, Stanley thought to himself, is to wait. Nothing will happen.
I didn't mean to do whatever I just did.
I can be happy forever. I will be happy. Stanley waited. Hours passed. Then days. Had years gone by? He no longer had the ability to tell. But the one thing he knew.
Sounds like a fairy tale.
Any doubt was that if he waited long enough, the answers would come. Eventually, someday, they would arrive. Soon, very soon now, this will end.
He will be spoken to.
He will be told what to do. Now it's just a little bit closer.
Is it gonna ring?
Now it's even closer.
This is kind of terrifying. Okay. Not sure what that was about.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo. No matter how hard Stanley looked, he couldn't find a trace of his co-workers.
He's just telling me what to do, huh? Oh, I interacted with something.
Stanley went around touching every little thing, but it didn't make a single difference.
Yeah. Let me have my fun, huh? Narrator. I will touch every little thing. Even if it doesn't advance the story, except maybe it does. I can't jump though. Username access.
Stanley came to a set of two open doors. He entered the door on his left.
Oh, that's what you want me to do, huh? I have a choice. Well, I never liked following orders.
And Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it.
Oh, perhaps, huh? Everything's locked. I mean, if everybody just disappeared, shouldn't there be more doors unlocked?
Ah, yes. Truly a room worth admiring. It had really been worth the detour after all, just to spend a few moments here in this immaculate, beautifully constructed room. Stanley simply stood here, drinking it all in.
Oh. Drinking it all in, huh? Tried to get a drink.
Really, really worth it being here in the room. A room so utterly captivating that even though all your co-workers have mysteriously vanished, here you sit looking at these chairs and some paintings.
Really worth it.
Really worth it.
Man, this is a sassy guy. I'm just gonna stand here until he says something still. Something more.
At this point, Stanley's obsession with
him bordered on creepy. Oh, you're not fun creepy, dude.
On his overall personality. It's possible this is why everyone left.
Right, everybody left because got a weird personality.
Stanley sat around waiting for more dialogue, but when a long time had passed and there was no more, he decided that the game was trying to send him a message.
Are you gonna get totally meta on me, huh? I'll wait for some more dialogue. Surely there's more. Right. I'm a patient man. Come on, say something. I dare you. What if I just trick you? Alright, so I'll move on.
But at last, he'd had enough of the amazing,
amazing room, huh?
Took the first open door on his left to get back to business.
You think I am, but I'm not. Oh, is he tricking me? He's gonna say that he tricked me, right? Does this look like a meeting room? Do not lie if you're lying.
Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible. It was 5 years ago.
This guy's out to get me, yo. If you're lying right now, stop. Oh, this is a cool looking place. Can I jump off? Kind of reminds me of Portal. It's got that weird atmosphere and the narrator that interacts with you, sort of. Do not jump from the cargo lift while it is in motion. Just jumping off cost you $5,000.
Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here. I'm not your enemy, really, I'm not. I realize that investing in your trust in someone else can be difficult, but the fact is...
Oh, I made it.
I was in the middle of something. Do you have zero consideration for others? Are you that convinced that I want something bad to happen to you?
Yes.
I don't know how to convince you of this, but I really do want to help you. To
show me something beautiful, huh?
Look, let me prove it. Let me prove that I'm on your side.
Give me a chance. How is he reaching me anyways? Danger everywhere. Sounds exciting. We're going on an adventure. The hell? I was stuck on the stairs. You're not gonna say anything, dude? It's kinda creepy as he keeps closing the door on me.
This is important. Stanley walked through the red door.
So important. How about I go to the right door? If there was a window, I'd jump out of it instead. The red door, huh? This time, I'm gonna... I think now he's trying to trick me, right?
Oh, thank God you are willing to listen to me.
No, never mind.
That I really
Shit.
Have wanted you to be happy all this time. The problem is all these choices.
Can I go back?
The two
Probably
of us
not.
Always trying to get somewhere that isn't here. Running and running and running just right. the way you're doing right now. Don't you see that it's killing us, Stanley?
This is
I
like,
just,
I'm trapped.
I wanted to stop. We would both be so much happier
creepy.
If we just stopped.
You want me
and
to
I
stop?
Think, well, I think I have a solution. Here, let me show you.
Creepy. Oh, that is creepy. There's nothing here. There's some strange voice.
What do we want? What are we looking for?
Is this the universe? Star. Star sky.
Yeah. If we just stay right here, right in this moment with
no.
this place, Stanley...
I'm going immediately.
No, wait. Where are you going?
I'm listening to that.
Oh no. Stay away from those stairs. If you hurt yourself, if you die, the game will reset. We'll lose all of this.
Oh, we're fine. It's just some stairs. They look sturdy enough.
Please, no, Stanley. Let me stay here. Don't take this from me.
What, is he trapped with me? Oh. It wants me to jump.
Please, Stanley, think about what you're doing.
Let me see what it says. It's kind of dark, making you jump and die. If I just stay here. Is he not gonna say anything else? I'll jump if you don't. I'll give you 5 seconds. Oh. Alright. I'm going for it. Oh, it didn't.
Thank God. You lived. You have
what?
Been worried there for a moment.
I'm not even limping.
Now, can we please get back to the other room?
Something in there upstairs? No? I guess I'll jump again.
No. No, no. What are you doing, Stanley? Please, I'm asking you not to take this away from me. I can't go back to what I was before. If you die, we'll both go back. Why are you doing this?
Go back to what, though? I'm sure it's not so bad.
Stanley,
one more time.
Let's go back to the other room. Oh God, is this really how much you dislike my game?
My game,
you
huh?
Throw yourself from this platform.
Is he Stanley then?
You were literally willing to kill yourself to keep me from being.
Wait, am I Stanley? I forget. Did he say his name?
Correctly?
That is what is happening, dude. Oh, one more time.
Maybe you're just getting a kick out of it. I don't know anymore. I just
oh, he's depressed
along.
Now.
But I guess that was too much to ask.
Oh.
It looks like you wanted to make a choice after all. Well, this one is yours.
This is Barbara's final time.
Is it over?
No.
It's going to restart, isn't it? I'm going back.
What? Is it going to just start the game over? Reload? But will it be the same? I wonder. Alright, we're back at the start. 4-7 still. But don't you start the game over here? Is he not gonna say anything?
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Everything seems the same as before. Oh wait, let me see. Awaiting input. pushing a bunch of buttons. $4.19. I guess I'll get back for that. Who farted? Huh. I'm sure there's something. I hate Mondays. Try to be observant. Alright, here's the two doors.
Came to a set of two open doors.
I mean, I could still... I could still go ahead and, like, do something else.
To the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it.
Oh yeah, I am Stanley. But yeah, he doesn't seem to recognize that we restarted. Although something might have changed, you know. I'm sure the game remembers it.
Wow, yes. This room. But eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
Alright, I guess I could go this time.
Through the maintenance section, walk straight ahead to the
opposite
door.
Yeah, here we have another choice. Track. Let me just go down here. Gotta explore. I'm always about finding those secrets. Are we going down to hell?
But Stanley didn't want to go back to the office. He wanted to wander about and get even further off track. So now in order to get back, he needed to go,
he's looking at the map.
From here, it's, left.
What? Don't I get to choose? Come on now.
Oh, no. No, it's to the right, my mistake.
What? Was that on the timer?
No.
You asshole, stop doing that.
Why would I have ever said it was to the right? What was I thinking?
Which one is it?
Oh dear, would you hold on for a minute, please?
Just open the door.
Now, let's see. We went down right, left, down, left, right. Yeah, yep, okay, okay, yes. I've got it now. This story is absolutely, definitely this way.
This is a completely different direction, dude. I guess maybe it's reading the script of the game, is that it? Ooh,
no,
what is this?
No,
the Matrix?
No.
Oh, this is totally the Matrix.
Not supposed to be here yet. This is all a spoiler.
Spoiler, huh?
Close your eyes. Okay. We just have to get back to,
104 is fired.
It's all rubbish now. Story
601 is fire.
How about rather than waste my time trying to salvage this nonsense, we'll just restart the game from the beginning. And this time, suppose we don't wander so far off track, hmm? Okay, from the top.
Ah, damn it. Not again. 601.
All of his code
and what was it?
Gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
I forgot it already. I'm sure you have to knock on the doors maybe in the correct order or something. For a secret ending or whatever, right? Wasn't that computer on before? Isn't that one that, like, needed the inputs or whatever? Yeah, it totally was. But now it's not on. That is strange. Oh, which one was it? 416? Forget.
When Stanley... Wait.
Oh.
What?
Oh, damn.
No, I restarted. I swear, I definitely restarted the game over, completely fresh. Everything should be...
So he does remember.
Oh, did something change? Stanley,
Did you change anything when we were back in that room with all the
monitors? Did you move the story somewhere?
Move the story somewhere, or hold on. Why am I asking you? I'm the one who wrote the story.
Is he God?
Was right here just a minute ago.
Is he the developer?
I'm sure that it's here somewhere. Okay then, it's an adventure. Come, Stanley, let's find the story.
I can't even go over here. But that's where I want to go. I guess I'll go over here. Oh wait, it leads to the same place. Let's find the story, huh? You're just holding back to let you torture yourself, inner guilt.
I'll say it. This is the worst adventure I've ever been on. I can promise you, there definitely was a story here before. Do we need to restart the game again?
Can we not restart?
I find it unlikely that we'll ever progress by starting over and over again.
Oh wait, I'm at the other side.
Okay, let's give it a shot. Why not? No.
Damn it, man, I was playing. Stop doing that shit. 427.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Was I like on a timer? Let me see if it's the same when I come back there. Oh, now there's nothing.
Okay.
All right.
It's worth.
It's worth.
I'm remembering this wrong. It's possible the story is back where we just came from. Why don't we go back?
This is trippy,
and see if we missed anything.
How about to just stay? It's making door sounds. Oh, yeah, it does that no matter where I click. Where's the music, dude? This is creepy. Go back to the start, huh?
I knew we'd miss something. The story. Here it comes.
Yeah, I went back to see if he had some more dialogue. Here it comes. It's right around the corner. Oh, this is an impossible space.
Wait, never mind. Not the story. Okay, let's head back the other way.
That man, make up your mind. Ooh, this is grimy looking.
Now this, well, I'll be honest, I don't recognize
this. This looks like Half-Life 2.
Is this the story? I don't think so. I can't quite recall, but I believe my story took place in an office building. Is that correct?
Oh, I've got to go somewhere else.
Do you remember, Stanley? Well, do you know what? Since I've completely forgotten what we were supposed to be doing, how about this?
Let's go find some aliens.
You win.
You win.
Congratulations. I know you put in a lot of
I feel so satisfied,
really
dude.
Paid off. So, good job.
Thanks.
Oh, no. No, I don't feel right about this at all. We both know you didn't put in any actual work for that. Some people win fair and square, and this was not one of those situations. Okay, I'm getting weirded out by whatever this place is. I don't care what might happen this time.
Restarting again?
Start.
Adventure line? What the hell?
All right, I've got a solution. This time, to make sure we don't get lost, I've employed
trademarked
the help of the Stanley Parable Adventure Line.
Uh-huh.
Just follow the line. How simple is that?
Follow the yellow line. It's like a Wizard of the the Wizard of Oz. I love that movie, by the way. This door wasn't open before. Let's not go in there.
No, I'm down. We're leaving it up to the line from now on.
Oh, you're not going to restart on me, are you? Just because I went in here, did. Guess I'll follow the line. She wants me to so badly. Oh, they're playing solitaire. Why can't I play?
You see? The line knows where the story is. It's over in this direction.
Stanley, to destiny. I skipped it.
Here's a thought. Wouldn't wherever we end up be our destination, even if there's no story there? Or to put it another
true
way,
that.
Is the story of no destination still a story?
A story about nothing?
Moving forward, are we implying a journey such that a destination is inevitably conjured into being via the...
Oh, you're getting philosophical on me, dude.
Of life itself? Okay, Stanley, I need to follow this train of thought for a minute. Just stick with me. Now we can...
It's kind of hard to stick with you, dude.
The nature of existence is in fact a byproduct of one subjective experience of that existence, right?
Right.
Okay. Now, if my experience of your existence rests inside of your subjective experience of this office, is this office, in fact, the skeleton of my own relative experiential mental subjective construct?
You lost me.
That got a bit weird back there. Well, I'd like to apologize. Not sure where I was going with all that. You know what? I think what we need right now is a bit of music to lighten the mood.
Wow. Oh, this is like some Banjo-Kazooie music right there. This is an adventure, right? This is crazy looking. Question mark. Oh, we're getting close to the first employee, number one. Or no, this maybe like Psychonauts music, what it sounds like. It's a bit goofy. Can you guys hear what I'm saying? What is number one? Oh. Look at me following the lion. This lion made by Spike. Oh,
go back and
thank
that fern.
What now? I don't even know where the fern is. I ran out.
Wait, what? We're back at the office? No, no, no. Lion, you do know we're looking for the Stanley Parable, right?
Oh, the lion is alive.
Is any of this ringing a bell?
It just goes back. Back here.
Oh, no, 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 not again. Line, how could you have done this to us? And after we trusted you, after everything we've been through, you... Oh, I can't take this anymore.
Oh,
restart.
104, this time I caught it. Or should remember it. 104. I mean, I'm not sure what I'm going to do with that information, but... this is crazy. I also noticed that those letters are yellow. I mean, not sure if it's relevant, but...
You know what, Stanley? I say forget the
oh,
eventual line.
Was
what's
I
it ever done for
too
us? We're intelligent people, right?
Slow.
Why can't we make up our own story? Something exciting, daring, mysterious. Ooh, this all sounds perfectly doable.
I mean, just living life is a story in itself, isn't it?
This direction.
I guess I'll cooperate.
Now, yes, this is
so exciting.
Just me and Stanley forging a new path, a new story. Well, it could be anything.
Oh, could you write me in the heart, babe?
To be. Go wild. Use your imagination.
And I got like
be, Stanley,
a hover bike. Hover.
It.
Hover car. I got superpowers. Anything, you know.
Oh, no, not you again. Stanley. I'd also like to veto the lion from having any role in our awesome new story.
Oh, wait, this came out of nowhere.
No lines or monitor rooms. Just don't acknowledge it, and we should be fine.
Look away. kind of hard to not see it. Because it's all over the place. Alright, where did it go?
Ah, a choice. We get to make a decision. From here, the story is in our control. How important
this is a cool looking room.
Squander the opportunity. In fact, I believe I need a minute to think here. Just walk in circles for a minute.
Oh, okay. The other way,
so
I mean?
I know that each door has to lead somewhere, which means that somewhere at the place where we're trying to go, there must be a reverse door that leads here. And that in turn means that our destination corresponds with the counter-inverted reverse door's origin. So starting from the right, let us ask, will taking the right door lead us to where we're going?
In real life, I would have picked the right door.
Yes, then by all accounts, the door on the right is the correct one. Another victory for logic. Come, Stanley. Our destiny awaits.
You're just gonna open both doors, dude. The confusing ending.
Hold up, what's this?
Confusion ending.
The confusion ending. You're telling me that's what this is? It's all one giant ending? And we're supposed to restart the game eight times?
Am I supposed to keep track of all this? After a long time, Stanley dies.
So now, according to the schedule, I restart again. Then what? Am I just supposed to
get bored and leave?
Well, what if I don't want to forget?
Find a bookstore.
Blank, simply because it's written here on this.
These are crazy
wall
stuff.
Well, who consulted me? Why don't I get to decide? Why don't I get a say in all of this? Is it really? No, it can't.
Oh, he's gonna forget at the fifth one.
I don't want the game to keep restarting. I don't want to forget what's going on. I don't want to be trapped like this. I won't restart the game. I won't do it. I won't do it. I won't do it.
My band does it too. Oh.
Stopped? Does that mean, did we do it? Did we break the cycle?
I love this sort of,
whatever it is that made this schedule.
Time travel stuff. Right?
Will someone come
time
something
loop.
Happen? So.
I mean, my favorite anime is Steins Gate.
I guess now
just saying.
You know, I suppose in some way that this is a kind of story, wouldn't you agree? I'm not quite sure if we're in the destination.
Confusion
the
ending schedule.
So
oh, this is right now.
Is about the journey and not the destination. So I hope that's where we are right now.
It's about to restart the game.
Eventually. Well, in the meantime.
Man, I was still reading. I tried to, you know, memorize it all. This is some crazy shit, yo. Alright, the game was restarted. So there's gonna be three more.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean?
I forgot what to do next, though.
To go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
I guess I'll cooperate. Oh wait, let me look at... It is that one. Why is it on that one time?
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his
own. Alright, I haven't gone there. I haven't actually gone to the meeting room yet, have I?
Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find an answer there.
Is there some hidden... Why is there something blurred out there? Everyone is unique. You most of all. Who's operating that? The power slides, I guess they could be automatic. Monetize, free to play, oh no. They got some evil plans. Help, I'm opposed to it. Oh, Did they all get transformed into like different objects? Is this like all the people? Like, this is a lot of writing for just one meeting, isn't it? Or whatever. There's lots of unique stuff here. Teenagers. Space between the teenagers. A lot of percent. The heck? Death sport portion in the primary review schedule. Death sport. For teenagers to put in teenage demographic. Some sort of child trap. I don't know, sounds kind of evil. Broom closet. Ooh, I can go in there.
Stanley stepped into the broom closet, but there was nothing here, so he turned around and got back on track.
Sure about that, dude?
There was nothing here. No choice to make.
All right,
no
I'll go.
Path to follow. Just an empty broom closet. Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Oh wait, let me go down. I want to see what's down here. Yeah, I thought I was sticking to a path, but I wasn't.
But Stanley just couldn't do
couldn't
it.
Do it though.
He considered the possibility of facing his boss, admitting he had left his post during work hours. He might be fired for that. And in such a competitive economy, why had he taken that risk? All because he believed everyone had vanished. His boss would think he was crazy. And then something occurred to Stanley. Maybe, he thought to himself, maybe I am crazy. All of my co-workers blinking mysteriously out of existence in a single moment for
I mean, I would think I would be crazy.
None of it made any logical
We're stuck
sense.
In a Black Mirror episode.
As Stanley pondered this, he began to make other strange observations. For example, why couldn't he see his feet when he...
Man, I should have paid attention to that, the whiteboard, huh?
...close automatically behind him wherever he went.
If he wanted to reach the... Oh.
These rooms were starting to look pretty familiar. Were they simply repeating?
I'm just going in a loop.
Stanley said to himself, this is all too strange. This can't be real. And at last, he came to the conclusion that had been on the tip of his tongue. He just hadn't found the words for it.
Nothing is real.
I'm dreaming! He yelled. This is all a dream. What a relief Stanley felt to have finally
this is no dream to
an explanation. His co-workers weren't actually gone. He wasn't going to lose his job. He wasn't crazy after all. And he thought to himself, I suppose I'll wake up soon. I'll have to go back to my boring real-life job pushing buttons. I may as well enjoy this while I'm still lucid. So he imagined himself flying and began to gently float above.
I got to fly. Cool.
Then he imagined himself soaring through space on a magical starfield, and it too appeared. It was so much
awesome.
Fun, and Stanley marveled that he had still not woken up. How was he remaining so lucid? And then perhaps the strangest question of them all entered Stanley's head. One he was amazed he hadn't asked himself sooner. Why is there a voice in my head dictating everything that I'm doing and thinking?
I was wondering about that.
How the voice was describing itself being considered by Stanley, who found it particularly strange. I'm dreaming about a voice describing me, thinking about how it's describing my thoughts, he thought. And while he thought it all very odd and wondered if this voice spoke to all people in their dreams, the truth was that of course...
I mean, I wish I had some narration in my life, maybe.
How could it be?
It would drive me insane, though,
himself,
this much.
Believing that if he's asleep, he doesn't have to take responsibility for himself. Stanley is as awake right now as he's ever been in his life. Now, hearing the voice speak these words was quite
It's more like a nightmare, huh?
After all, he knew for certain, beyond a doubt, that this was in fact a dream. Did the voice not see him float and make the magical stars just a moment ago? How else would the voice explain all that? This voice was a part of himself too. Surely, surely, if he could just... He would prove it. He would prove that he was in control. That this was a dream.
How exactly?
He closed his eyes gently.
No,
he
no, no.
He invited himself to wake up. He felt the cool weight of the blanket on his skin.
the press of the mattress on his back, the fresh air of a world outside this one. Let me wake up, he thought to himself. I'm through with this dream. I wish it to be over. Let me go back to my job. Let me continue pushing
buttons. Oh, he's just dying to get back to that job, huh?
It's all I want.
Pushing buttons.
I want my apartment and my wife.
Oh, yes, a wife.
My job. All I want is my life exactly the way it's
always been. I don't think they told us that before.
My life is normal. I am normal. Everything will be fine. I am okay.
Time for a restart. I'm still in the same place.
Stanley began screaming. Please, someone wake me up. My name is Stanley. I have a boss. I have an office. I am real. Please, just someone tell me I am real. I must be real. I must be. Can anyone hear my voice? Who am I? Who
spooky.
Am
I?
And everything went black.
Okay.
This is the story of a woman named
Mariella.
They
did say that it's going to go black.
Mariella woke up on a day like any other. She arose, got dressed, gathered her belongings,
and now we're playing as her.
To her place of work. But on this particular day, her walk was interrupted by the body of a man who had stumbled through town talking and screaming to himself.
Oh, Stanley went insane.
Dead on the sidewalk. And although she would soon turn to go call for an ambulance, for just a few brief moments, she considered the
strange. Stanley, isn't it?
He was obviously crazy. This much she knew. Everyone knows what crazy people look like. And in that moment, she thought to herself how lucky she was to be normal.
But is she normal?
I am sane. I am in control of my mind. I know what is real and what isn't. It was comforting to think this. And in a certain way, seeing this man made her feel better.
Would you like to compare ourselves to others?
For that day, the very important people whose impressions of her would affect her career, and by extension, the rest of her life. She had no time for this, so it was only a moment that she stood there, staring down at the body.
I don't know, it seems like quite a long time to me. She didn't have to run. Or I guess she was running out of time. Gonna start over? Yes?
All of his co-workers were gone.
I was supposed to follow the line again in one of them.
Simply missed a memo.
But I guess I deviated.
Came to a set of two open doors. He entered the door on his left.
Right, this time. This is the one where I'll follow directions.
Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley
don't get fired.
To his
talk less.
Office, hoping he might find an answer there.
Take it out passive aggressively. I didn't notice this. Resent co-workers. Oh, what a circle. Using slides to assure employees that everything is okay. Slick blue graphic, huh? Oh, is that me on the left there? I wonder how many slides there are. Is this going faster than it was before? Number of slides on this slide. Rate of increase in graphs per slide. Oh, this is goofy. Please no more shards. Oh, I think he's noticing that I'm looking at it. Top 20 things you love most about your boss. Alright. Conflict with another employee like yourself? Why did we hire you? What are your dreams of the future? Comatose? Why is that there? I want to be comatose. Alright. It repeated.
Coming
guess I'll
staircase,
go upstairs.
Upstairs to his boss's office.
Ooh, look at this. This is a fancy looking office.
Stepping into his manager's office, Stanley was once
again. This is so tall. The ceiling just got taller and taller.
Any human life. Shocked, unraveled, Stanley wondered in disbelief who orchestrated this. What dark secret was being held from him? What he could not have known was that the keypad behind the boss's desk guarded the terrible truth
that
his boss had been keeping from him. And so the boss had assigned it an extra secret PIN number. 2845. But of course, Stanley couldn't possibly. Yet incredibly, by simply pushing random buttons on the keypad, Stanley happened to input the correct code by sheer luck. Amazing.
He stepped into the newly opened passageway. I'll just play piano. I do know how to play piano a little bit. I do have a keyboard and a MIDI controller, so I guess I should know. Oh, this is just... Am I sure this is the right way, dude? It looks kind of shady. I'm probably going for two different endings, huh? I should have followed the whiteboard, but I guess I'm not. Because that was going for the Confucian ending, and now I'm going on the regular ending-ish? Where you just follow everything he says? Maybe.
Descending deeper into the building, Stanley realized he felt a bit peculiar. It was a stirring of emotion in his chest, as though he felt more free to think for himself, to question the nature of his job. Why did he feel this now, when for years it had never occurred to him? This question would not go unanswered for long.
Yeah, totally Portal 2 vibes.
Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read
"Mind what the heck? Facility." Oh, escape. Oh, I'm being mind controlled. I guess I should escape then.
Although this passageway had the word "escape" written on it, the truth was that
but this is an endless hallway.
Stanley would meet his violent death.
I don't believe you did. Oh, this is trippy.
The door behind him was not shut. Stanley still had every opportunity to turn around and get back on track.
I'm not being controlled anymore.
At this point,
I'm Stanley free of your shackles.
A conscious, concerted effort to walk forward and willingly confront his death.
Should have had a monster sneak up on you, maybe. Is that the gate? Where's the lid? You see a dark hole, you jump down it. It's like in Silent Hill. Love those games, by the way. Proper creepy. 1 and 2 are my favorites. But yeah, I guess the narrator is trying to mind control you. It's not always working. What was that about my death, dude? Oh, I'm stuck.
Stanley was inched closer and closer to his demise. He reflected that his life had been of no consequence.
I guess he wasn't lying.
Stanley can't see the bigger picture. He doesn't know the
reason. I'm gonna get squished.
Trapped forever in his narrow vision of what this world is. Perhaps his death was of no great loss, like plucking the eyeballs from a blind man.
What else is it? Designed a place to walk over there.
This violent end to his brief and shallow life. Farewell, Stanley.
Farewell. No!
Farewell, Stanley, cried the narrator, as Stanley was led helplessly into the enormous metal jaws. In a single visceral instant, Stanley was obliterated as the machine crushed every bone in his body, killing him instantly.
Ah, that does not sound pleasant. There's a female narrator. Oh, is it over?
And yet it would be just a few minutes before Stanley would restart the game back in his office, as alive as ever. What exactly did the narrator think he was going to accomplish?
How much have I got there? Does it restart? I was trying to walk around it. Ooh, this is
when every pass
interesting looking.
Has been created for you long in advance. Death becomes meaningless, making life the same. Do you see now? Do you see that Stanley was already dead from the moment he hit start?
Nature paintings. Didn't these appear? Yeah, this totally appeared when we walked around the building. Stanley's computer. Oh, that's like a museum office layout. They're talking about the development of the game. Yeah, it looks pretty accurate. Well, we have to reach the doors in a good time, huh? Filing cabinets. Very interesting. We don't see them in every game. Is that in real life? Just about. The contradiction at this room. Post. The office. I love that show. Button size. I never saw any of these. Makes different sounds. Strange. Office computers. Employee database. Too difficult to read. No, it's got credits and everything. Kevin Brightthing. The Impeccable. As the narrator. Oh, this is a Source game. I was wondering about that, actually. By Valve? Did Valve really make this? Shit. I didn't know. But it totally felt like a Source game. Stanley. There's no secret here, is there? Guess not. Oh, there's two ways. Let me go to the one that doesn't look like the office. Oh, there's more. Is this concept art? Guess I'll go up here. Freedom ending? Oh, is that like the best ending? Where you reach freedom? Are you gonna see all of the different endings? I'm guessing this is one of the endings, right? The countdown ending. 32, what? Did I have the opportunity to push that button? But I missed it. 78. Strange. The beta version, huh? Monitor room. Elevator. Go up and down. Freedom above and countdown below. It was too difficult to remember what was up and what was down. Strange. Countdown room. I haven't been there yet. Right. But it leads to freedom ending supposedly. on off. I'm not gonna go in there yet. And what is that? Game design mock-up. This is a long time without narration, huh? The level designer sent Davy audition piece. Oh, this is like the pilot game environment. Oh, it looks kind of generic, doesn't it? Not sure what's so interesting about that, but oh well. Oh, it's behind some glass. Stanley's office. 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 This game took 3 years to make. It was such a simple game. It looks fine on each of these, doesn't it? Oh well. There is some more stuff I haven't seen there. I mean, there's a bunch of stuff, really. Apart, there's a. Oh, ending. Oh wait, this is. Yeah, it exists somewhere else, huh? Interesting. Apartment timer. I guess it's showing me all the different stuff that I can unlock. Oh, is that... That's not the cargo lift. We haven't been there either. Not here. Oh wait, it's like different versions, huh? No, it is where I was, or... I guess they're not showing it? Or was it this one? It doesn't look like either of those, but... I was with a cargo lift where I could jump off. Did I have more than one? The game is now paused. Escape menu. Unfortunately, very few players realized they were supposed to restart the game from the escape menu. I hate it when games do that, though. Right, screw that. I'm way too patient for it, you know? I'll just sit there forever. Sending levers. I'm sure that there's an ending somewhere in here, right? Instead of going out to hit that switch. Sending. Interesting. Sending. Oh, cut and merge with another part of the game. Okay, that really looks like Portal, like a puzzle. Oh, is this back to where I started? There was something else. Oh, I haven't looked at this. How many endings are there anyways? Yeah, that does not look very interesting, huh? This design. Forgot which way I came from. Well, this is new. Meeting room. One option. Doorway. Oh, way to get there. Is that it? The vent. You can go to the vent. Two confusion ending. Ah, shit. Two confusion ending. All of them have a way to the confusion ending, huh? Obey, disobey. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay, I'll see. I didn't even read that. First choice. Disobey. Launch. Maintenance. That's what I did the first time, isn't it? Vent. Oh, this is just a different. Didn't I go with the first one? I feel like there was. Oh, yeah, I mean, of course, there's the ending place. Did I don't go down here, though. HD remix. More endings, fewer endings. More narrators, fewer narrators. More Stanley, less Stanley. HD remix is the point of it is to win. What is this? Green lights. Am I playing the HD remix? 6 years ago. Oh, these are the photos they used, huh? Was that clock there before? How do I go back? Interesting. I've been down there. Maintenance room. Oh no, this is where I didn't go. I think I've been there everywhere now, right? Guess I'll go to that room. As in the only place to go, right? Oh, I haven't seen this. What is that Tron-looking stuff? That's just where I want to go. Stan would end up on a battlefield fighting aliens. That's what I want to do. Wage war against the narrator. Oh, that sounds awesome. Too jokey and on the nose. Hey, now I would have appreciated it. I want to go there. Alien base. Awesome. I agree. I'll totally fight the narrator. The launch. Oh wait, I haven't seen this either. I keep. Are you a rock? Question. Narrator emails. Well, playing the Stanley Parable helped me make friends. I don't have any friends. Oh, poor Saul. There's a skeleton inside of you. Oh, there are more skeletons in the world than humans. I mean, that's true and all. 1112800. 1112800. Should I write it down? I don't really feel like it. I don't really feel like getting a pen and paper. That's what I'm saying. I guess they're not important-ish. Are they that interesting? Should I keep reading? Gay, are you gay? Dink dunk. What the heck? Congratulations. Oh, this is totally a scam email. How do you make a JRPG? What is the difference between a duck? How is that relevant? I love our JRPGs though. That's Strong Bad. How do you have your boxing gloves on? Oh, I love Strong Bad. I've seen those episodes where he's like typing emails and shit. This totally reminds me of that. Capybaras. What's a capybara? Quackster. All right, it went. It looped. Now let me find the way out. Oh wait, wasn't this in a different place? Maybe not. Was it over here? Down there? Yeah.
Oh, look at these two. How they wish to destroy one another. How they wish to control one another. How they both wish to be free.
Guess I'll push it. Turning the game off.
Can you see? Can you see how much they need one another? No, perhaps not. Sometimes these things cannot be seen.
She's talking about Stanley and the Nurturer. They need each other.
You can still save these two. You can stop the program before they both fail. Push escape and press quit. There's no other way to beat this game.
I'm not gonna do that.
Forward, you'll be walking someone else's path. Stop
now. Might mess with the recording.
True choice. Do choose it. Don't let time choose for you. Don't let...
Quit the menu. No.
Time choose.
I was going to see if it had like a unique option there, but going to restart the game again. This has been an hour. I wonder, should I like do it in two segments? Why it's just dark now? Am I just supposed to wait? I don't want to skip any dialogue or anything. Cutscene. Oh, I can still pause the game. But yeah, they said that you don't have to restart the game in any of the endings. So surely I don't have to restart the game, right? I'll just sit there. I'm fine. This is fine. So how was your day? Actually, I guess I could try and walk. And click the mouse. And spacebar. Resume the game. Well, it did say in that whiteboard that everything would go dark. Options. Man, this is interesting, isn't it? I guess I could begin the game again. I mean, this is such a weird option, so I guess it could be okay. And not, you know, mess everything up. Yeah, I gotta try it. I got kind of bored of waiting in the dark. But we're back. Took a while to load.
The meeting room. Yes, that's where everyone would be. Stanley just needed to get to the meeting room, and from then on, he would never be alone ever again.
Let me try and get the confusion ending again.
When Stanley came to a set of two open, this was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well.
I'm just making my playtime longer and longer, aren't I?
First, just to admire it. The lounge was sublime, a work of art. But eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
It does lead to the meeting, but you can also go down. Oh, let me try this.
Stanley was following
staying on the lift, maybe.
He wasn't 5 years ago. Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here. I'm not your enemy, really, I'm not. I realize that investing in your trust in
but I totally feel like the game has restarted completely.
The story has been about nothing but you
right.
All this time. There's someone you've been neglecting, Stanley. Someone you've forgotten about. Please, stop trying to make every decision by yourself.
Oh, you know what?
I'm asking for her.
Maybe I should have turned on like the Steam overlay. I have it off.
to put your work aside,
because
to let her back into your life, she's been waiting.
What? Because I mean, games like these typically have achievements where they tell you the game is, you got that and that ending or whatever, maybe. Jesus, that scared the shit out of me. Well, that was the phone that, with the timer, right? Two different endings. And now we're in the apartment-ish.
Hold on, sweetie. Sorry to keep you waiting. I'm just pulling the bread out of the oven. Alright.
But this is his office number.
Alright now, I want you to come in and tell me all about
your day.
Creepy.
Gotcha! Oh, come on. Did you actually think you had a loving wife?
You mentioned the wife earlier.
I'm trying to make a point here, Stanley. I'm trying to get you to see something.
I'm inching forward.
Let me show you what's really going on here.
Really creepy. Please don't come alive.
This is a very sad story about the death of a man named Stanley.
Press Y on your keyboard, huh? Do I have to? I guess I will.
Stanley is quite a boring fellow. He has a job that
demands. I hope he doesn't tell me to push F9.
That he pushes is a reminder of the inconsistency.
Because that stops my recording. Press K.
Look at him there, pushing buttons, doing exactly what he's told to do. Now he's pushing a button. Now he's eating lunch. Now he's going home. Now he's coming back to work. One might even feel sorry for him, except that he's chosen this life.
Did he choose it, though?
But in his mind,
Please press X.
He can go on fantastic adventures. From behind his desk, Stanley dreamed of wild expeditions into the unknown. Fantastic discoveries of new lands. It was wonderful.
Wasn't it this?
That he returned to work was a reminder that none of it would ever happen to him.
Kind of terrible, this place right there. Press O to watch TV.
And so he began to fantasize about his own job. First, he imagined that one day while at work, he stepped up from his desk to realize that all of his co-workers, his boss, everyone in the building.
Oh, that was just an imagining.
The face of the earth.
Just having some fun, huh?
Excited him terribly.
It's all Stanley. Spent time with the boys.
So he went further. He imagined that he came to two open doors and that he could go through either.
Oh, it's all his imagination.
It barely even mattered what lay behind each door. The mere thought that his decisions would mean something was almost too wonderful to behold.
Stanley's got a vivid imagination, you know.
As he
prepared dinner.
This fantasy world, he began to fill it with many possible paths and destinations. Down one path lay an enormous round room with monitors and mind controls.
They're clipping into that.
And down another was a yellow line that weaved in many directions. And down another was a game with a baby. And he called it the Stanley Parable.
Oh, he's talking about the different endings, huh? One with the baby.
It was such a wonderful fantasy. And so in his head, he relived it again. And then again. And again, over and over, wishing beyond hope that it would never end, that he might always feel this free. Surely there's an answer down some new path, mustn't there be? Perhaps if he played just one more
just
time.
Just one more time, huh? Press L to tell your wife lover.
But there is no answer. How could there possibly be?
Press F to pay respects.
Pushing the same buttons he always has.
Well, now we're in the office, changed. Huh?
The longer he spends here, the more invested he gets, the more he forgets which life is the real one.
Can I save the game, by the way? I guess I can't. I guess I'm just stuck playing the game forever.
In this world, he can never be anything but an observer. That as long as he remains here, he's slowly killing himself. But he won't listen to me. He won't stop. Here, watch this. Stanley. The next time the screen asks you to push a button, do not do it.
Alright. Oh wait, they told me not to do it. That means I should do it. Maybe not. I don't want to go. I don't want to get restarted. Oh, wait. I think. Oh, yeah, there's an extra. So yeah, it has saves. Oh, achievement. Why is this an extra though? Is it bad if I turn that on? Can I save now? Save. Because I just, in the interest of time, I mean, it's getting kind of late. How the fuck do I do this? But I think I'll just call it there, actually. Well, let's see if something happens if I don't press it. Kind of a weird spot to stop, isn't it? But yeah, I looked at the extras thing before, just a tiny bit, before I started the game. Did tell me to try not press it. I guess I'll find out what happens next time. But if there are that many endings, I mean, I'm sure there's lots more stuff to do in this game, right? Although that could have been one of the endings, I guess. The one where you saw everything. The most boring ending. Probably, right? Most standard one. To just egg you on to keep playing and get to different ones. Let me see if that timer is going. Yeah, I'll stay here for a minute. Or half a minute. Did it move? This is ground-breaking entertainment right there. But yeah, I've enjoyed the game so far. It's very, very quirky, very unique, I guess. Oh, did it? It is moving. I mean, doesn't really mean anything. All right, but yeah, it's probably a bit much to ask of somebody to just sit and get all of the endings in one go, huh? But I think I got one of them. It didn't really it didn't mention it anywhere in the museum, though. Or whatever you call that. Showcase. They could have called it, like, the standard ending. Or something, right? Female narrator. I guess I could go and save, go back to that place. Shit, I should have turned on saving before and saved right before that. And then, when she told me to quit to the menu or whatever, I should have done that. Right. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed my gameplay. Let's play. And I'll see you guys next time, right? Peace.